Okay, so this is, we're gonna have a test on 3.3 and 3.4. 3.3, properties of logs. Okay, properties of logs. The very first thing that you have to know is what's called the change of base formula. Now, if you used one of the school calculators, they're not all, but I would say the majority of the school calculators, do y'all know how to put this in your calculator? Yes? Okay, I do math alpha math. That's just the fastest, easiest way to me. Okay, and what it's going to do is pull up this. Thanks, come on. All right, now. Some, if it's a school calculator, they disabled it. And the reason is because this is an Algebra 2 key, an Algebra 2 skill. And so if you were, like you should be, taking the Algebra 2 end of course test, nobody is. All right, they're not doing that. But anyway, I wish we were doing it because I'd like to see how my kids are doing. But if we were taking the Algebra 2 end of course test, then this would be a skill that they would be testing, and so they disable that function on the calculator so that you have to know the change of base formula. So, since it's, I'm not policing your calculators, all right, then I'm just going to require that you show your work. Anytime you have a problem that says, use the change of base formula, if you get the answer right and you don't show your work, I will not give you credit for it. Did everybody hear me? Okay? If you get the answer right and you don't show your work, I will not give you credit for it. So here is the change of base formula. It says log base A, that means anything. I don't care what the base is, of X. What if the base? I mean, what's the only thing my calculator really does besides that little nifty trick we made it do? What's the log button on your calculator?
Oh, base 10.
Base 10. What's the LN button on your calculator? Base of E. So used to be that was the only thing that they did, all right? Now we've got this cool thing, but they still want you to know the change of base. Here's what it's going to be. I can use any base that I want to. Obviously, I'm either going to use a base 10 or a base E because those are the two that my calculator will do without a doubt, okay? So you're going to, I'm going to do base 10 first, okay? As long as these two bases are the same, it'll work. Now look at these two things. Who do you think is going to go on top, X or A? X. Who do you think is going to go on bottom? A. Yep. Or you can do ln of X over ln of A. Oh, yeah, you're going to have a calculator, okay? So let's try a problem. Here's example one. Now here's the directions. Use the change of base formula. So what's the teacher going to be looking for? Okay. All right. So here's the first, well, here's, I think it's the only one we're going to do. What if I was trying to find log base 4 of 25? Okay. Now, what would the change of base formula say it is? Log 25 over, that's a 2, looks like a 5. Log 25 over log 4, or what else? Ln of 25 over ln of 4. Now, both of them are going to give you the same answer, guys. Mm-hmm. So, you take your calculator, and you'd say log 25. Now, what do I have to do right here? Yeah, if you don't close the parentheses, guys, you're going to keep taking the log all the way through the problem, okay? Divided by log 4. Or you can do ln. Ln of 25, close those parentheses, divided by ln of 4. So as long as these two bases, here's the concept. As long as this base and this base are the same, then it makes it work out. You could even do it like this. You could even say log base 3 of 25 over log base 3 of 4. See, you could even do it that way. You'll still get the same answer. But you could not do log 25 over ln of 4. That's not going to work. Okay? But either one of these will give you your answer, which was what? 2.322? All right. Anybody got a question? Everybody okay on the change of base formula? So, whenever you, the first thing I'm going to do is look and see, do you have that answer right? If you have that answer right, you either have to have this on your paper or this on your paper. Okay? You have to show me that you know the change of base formula. I don't give a hoot that you can go math, alpha, math, plug a 4 in the bottom box and a 25 in the top box. Okay? That's not what I'm testing. All right. Let's talk about this. These are properties. Now, before we talk about them, I want to show you that you already know these. Okay? We haven't even talked about them, but you already know them. What is x to the second times x to the third? X to the fifth. Okay? Because when you multiply, what do you do with your exponent? All right. What is x to the seventh over x to the fourth? Because when you divide, what do you do with your exponent? What is x to the second raised to the third? Because powers to powers, you do what? All right, so this is what you learned last year. Remember, we did a little, what's it called, an acronym? Is that what it is? Okay, a little acronym to help you remember that. So you have to have a positive mental attitude during school. And here's the way it goes. Powers to powers, you multiply. When you multiply, you add your exponent. And when you divide, you subtract them. Okay? Now, what's a logarithm? Oh. So, these properties that are true to exponents hold true for logarithms too, right? Okay, so those are the properties. That's what I'm talking about. You already know them. Okay, so let's write them down. Properties. There's only three, right? Properties. Of log. I mean, that's how many we just did. 3. All right. So, now look. It'll go for either way. Either a log base anything, or you can do it with a natural log. So, we'll do the log base anything's over here and the natural log's over here. All right. So, log base A. That means that's base anything, guys. Don't care what the base is, 10, 9, 7, 14, whatever. Log base A of U times V. Now, when you multiply, what do you do with those exponents? You add them. So, y'all, this is log base A of U plus log base A of V. You add your exponents. X to the second times x to the third. 2 plus 3. All right, what about this one? Oh, let's do it over here. Ln of u times v. What's that going to be? Ln of u plus ln of v. Very good. All right, what about this one? Log base a of u over v. Now, what are they doing? Yeah. Divide, you subtract. So that's going to be log base A of U minus log base A of V. Do y'all remember this from last year? Over here, it's going to look like ln of U over V. Ln of U minus ln of V. Notice this, guys, that if it's on the bottom of a fraction, it's subtracted. So anything that's subtracted, I don't care where it is, because look, you might have like 4 terms here. If it's subtracted, where does it belong? No. On the bottom. And if it's positive or it's added, where does it belong? On the top. Okay? All right, so this is the one that kids, I would say, most of the time, not really sure about. Okay, so look what this one is. Now, what's a logarithm? So this is like a power raised to a power. No, powers to powers, what do? You multiply. So watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to multiply the exponents, right? So here's one of them. Do you agree with that? So he comes out front, and then he multiplies by this exponent. No, it's u to the n. It's log base a of u to the n power.
What does she begin?
The bases aren't the same. If it was log base a of a to the n, it would be n. That's a property. Okay? All right, over here, ln of u to the n is equal to n times ln of u. All right, so let's talk about how we're going to use this. There's two things that we can do. We can condense and expand. What does condense something mean? Make it smaller. So this side over here on the left, that is the condensed version. Okay, over here it's the same thing. This is the condensed. What does expand mean? All right, so this is expanding it, dragging it out, all right? So here's what's going to happen. On the test, the whole entire front page is kind of like condense and expand, all right? I'm going to give it to you like this and say condense that. Or I'm going to give it to you like this and say expand that. Yeah, it's not bad, all right? Look, did I save the hardest part for last? Is this hard?
No.
Okay. Y'all, I'm saving the hardest part for last, okay? Please, do y'all want to do something really hard now? No. Half of you already quit, all right? So I'm like dragging you by your toenails through this thing. So here we go. Example number one. They want me to expand. All right? Here's the first one. Log base 5 of 2x to the third. Oh. All right. So when you expand, here are the rules. Anything that's raised to a power, you pull the exponent out front and multiply. Anything that's multiplied, you're going to add. Anything that's divided, you're going to subtract, okay? So those are, y'all, there's only three rules. Multiply, you add, divide, you subtract, and powers go out front. That's it. Okay, so tell me what you're going to write down. Five.
So it's three times log.
No, no, no.
It's log base 5 of 2.
Very good. Okay, so I did this one purposefully because 9 times out of 10, kids think that's 2x to the third. It's 2 times x to the third. Whenever they multiply, what are you supposed to do? You got to separate them. You got to add, guys. Okay, so you have to separate there. Those are not permanently stuck together. So it's going to be log base 5 of 2. They multiplied, so we add. And then, what happens to this exponent? It comes out front, and then 3 times log base 5 of x. Now, think about what you just said. Does this exponent go to that 2?
No.
No, he doesn't even go to the 2. It's 2 times x to the third. It's not 2x raised to the third. You'd have to use parentheses. Okay, so you ready for another one?
Yeah.
All right, here's your next one. Log base 4 of 5x to the third y.
Ooh.
Okay, you got it? What did you write? Log base 4 of 5. 3 log base 4 of x. Very good. All right. Anybody got a question? Okay, so let's do this next one. Like this one's given to you, I want you to make sure it's a you use a radical if you need to. When it's expanded, you're going to need to write that with an exponent. So that is ln of 3x minus 5 to what power? 1/2. Okay? Remember how fractional exponents make roots. So roots are on the bottom, powers are on the top. So square root's 1/2. What's cube root? 1/3. What's fifth root? Okay, and we don't. That just all goes together. Okay. So now, when they divide, what are you going to do? Subtract. So the first thing is this 1/2 comes out front. You can't separate that, guys. You have to keep it together. All right. And then they divided. So what are we going to do? And that's it. So, be careful, because look, when I see this as an expanded version and they ask me to condense, then my brain has to go, oh, that's a 1/2. I'm going to have to write that as a radical, okay? When it's condensed, it has to be written as a radical. Brent? It's not that it's illegal. It's just what's proper, okay? When it's condensed, we write it with a radical. When it's expanded, we write it with an exponent. Okay? All right. Then I'll count off. Mm-hmm. All right, so let's do this one. Last one on this full part. All right, you expand that one. I like these. These are easy. Did you drink some water? Did you drink some water? Looks like you had a headache. So you're 100. Okay. All right, you ready? Okay. So, tell me what you write first. Log what? 3. I'm not going to do it in parentheses. I'm not going to count it wrong if you do, but I'm going to show you why I'm not going to do it in parentheses. I'm just going to say minus what? And then minus. Okay? Yeah, if you put a parentheses around, then you have to write it like this. And there's nothing wrong with that, but look, here's what happens. When kids write it like this, then sometimes, like, watch what I could do to that problem right there. I could give you this problem right here. Log 3 minus log z plus log x minus 4 log y. Now, you see how I mixed it all up? Okay? If kids are used to writing it like this, they don't quite understand all that. And they might even put this with this because that's a plus, so it's multiplied by this one is what they think. And then make a complex fraction by putting that on the bottom of something that's already the bottom of a fraction. Okay? But here's the rule, guys. If it's positive, it's on the top. So this 3 and this x, they should be on the top. If it's negative, it's on the bottom. So this z is on the bottom, and this y to the fourth is on the bottom. All right? So I write it like this because I think when I write it like this, kids tend to not get tricked when it's given to them like this. Okay, so let's go the other way. If that was expanding, pardon me, then example 6 is going to be condensed. All right? Now, when you condense, how many times can I write the word log?
One
time. Y'all, you write it more than one time and you're out. All right? You just lost. You missed that problem. So, here's the first one. That's too long. 10, so I don't have to write it. No, let's make it hard. Boom, there you go. 6 times. Look, people, it's just a process. Just a process, okay? You think so? Probably less likely. Yeah, probably less likely to make a mistake. Expanding, y'all, the biggest mistake is when you have something like 2x, and they don't pull that 2 off. That's a coefficient. It's multiplied. You've got to pull it off. Now, let's be proper, okay? So when you have a bunch of letters, what kind of order do they go in? Just any way they come? Alphabetical order, okay? So let's put it in the right kind of order. I might take a point off or something. That's crazy. Y'all know
you're
that kind
crazy.
Of stuff.
That's crazy.
I'm not crazy.
Yes, you are. That's a
no.
Tiny.
Yeah, because look at that table up there. You know I'm obsessively tiny.
We are putting alphabet.
All right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to write the word log one time. And then I'm just going through it. Now, I will tell you this, that I always do this. Anything that's out front, I go and just rewrite it as an exponent. That keeps me from dropping and forgetting about stuff. Okay? Now I don't have to think about those anymore. Okay, so 4, where does he go? On the top. All right? Where does x squared go? On top. To the back.
Remember what I said.
If you write the word log more than one time, you're out. You missed it. Okay? You can only write, and that is one of the most common mistakes. very, very common for kids to look at that and write log of the top over log of the bottom, okay? Even if I have a note in my book, make sure, be careful, this is the most common mistake, okay? See it all the time. What's the other one? Nope, I wouldn't. Okay? All right, want to do another one? Dadgum. The same.
That
what
we got.
We got
10 minutes to work like 3 problems.
I think we're good with just working one. Give us
the
hard one.
Give us the next part.
And then we'll be done.
The next hardest one?
Give us the hard one. We'll be done.
All right.
Give us the really, really hard
one. Okay. Y'all like, boy, y'all are some workers now. It's not your last one. I have a different type of problem to do, but I can give you the hardest one and see how you go. Y'all, look, it's all about being proper, okay? So, properly, in math, you start out using parentheses, and then what's the next thing you use?
Brackets.
And what's the next thing you use?
Braces.
And then you go back to parentheses and brackets and braces, okay? That's actually what we do. You guys have gotten out of that habit because your calculator, you only use parentheses. And does he care how many times you use it?
No,
he doesn't care. Do you use the brackets on the calculator? If you have to be careful, because a lot of times you use a bracket and your calculator will think you're trying to do a matrix. Okay? So a lot of times he'll say you got an error because he's going, whoa, wait, that's not a matrix. Yeah. So I always tell my kids don't use a bracket on a calculator.
Put the x in there.
Thank you, Ben.
Hey,
you got your worksheet?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Miss Davis.
Huh?
Do I need to put the x squared minus 4x or can I leave the x out?
X squared. No, you can just leave that.
When you put x times x minus 4.
Mm-hmm. All right, so log base 2 of, what does this one-third mean?
Cube root.
Cube root of what? When they add, what are you going to do?
Multiply.
So it's just x times x minus 4. That's it. That's all it is. Okay. All right, one more problem and then we'll be through. Okay, here it is. This is example. I skipped examples 3 and 4 because 3 is weird.
Expanding or what?
Neither. And 4 is not weird, but
yeah,
it's a little different.
Yeah.
I said one more. I
no.
really said 3 more, and y'all said just give us the hardest one.
This isn't expanding or
no, it's not. Okay. So here's what they're asking me to do. Verify.
Verify.
Oh, like in the trig identities. Y'all remember that? We're dead.
No,
remember? Sine theta over cosine theta equals tan
no.
theta. All that kind of stuff. All right. It's not going to be bad. Well, you don't have to. Huh? Because I'm not using them. What? I'll show you. Okay, no, that's not how you do it. Okay, so remember when we verified identities? That was where they gave you two things, and you knew they were equal to each other, but you had to work on one side and try to make it look like the other side. Which side do you always start working on? The messiest side, okay? So which side's messier, the left or the right? Okay, so we're going to work on this side. Okay, so let's see. Oh, I see this. Can I rewrite this as 100 to some power? What is 1 over 100? 100 to the what power? Negative 1. Very good. A negative exponent will move that to the bottom. All right? Oh, it's a logarithm raised to a power. What do you do with that exponent? Do what? Bring him to the front. So it's negative 1 times negative log base 10 of 100. What's a negative times a negative? There you go. Now that wasn't so bad.
Hey, we're done.
Yep, now we're done.